librarian at the Baltimore County Public Library at the Towson branch, and today we will be talking about monster plants. Today's edition is Medusa. Who was Medusa? Medusa was a character out of Greek mythology. She was a terrifying gorgon with snakes for hair, and anybody that looked at her would turn to stone. We have some really great books and stories about her, but a lot of people have enjoyed reading about her in the Percy Jackson series. Wonderful series of books. But if you go to our website, bcpl.info, and check out our catalog, you'll find a lot of really great books under kids for Medusa. What does Medusa have to do with plants? Well, I'm going to introduce you to a type of plant today. This is the Euphorbia family, and you can see there's a great amount of variety in them. And the Euphorbia come from South Africa, and they are really cool plants. Now, these are not necessarily great plants to have around pets because their sap is actually poisonous. So, how's that for a start for a monster? They named a plant after Medusa. It looks like snakes. And here's another Medusa plant, a slightly different species. And coolest of all, a monster Medusa. And what is a monster Medusa? Well, sometimes plants that start off looking like this will mutate, and you can see these are all flat and really different looking. It's an absolutely beautiful plant. The story of Medusa is also the story of Perseus. And Perseus was a Greek hero, and he decided that he needed Medusa's head because, of course, she could turn anybody who attacked her, and she looked at them to stone. Well, he was able to fight her and win and use her head in his battles. Today, we're also going to do a craft, how to make your own Medusa. So here's sort of the finished product. And you can see we had snakes for hair. You will need two paper plates. And the first paper plate is where you'll paint and make your Medusa. Or you can color with crayons or markers, whatever you have around the house. But having pipe cleaners is really useful for making your snakes. So let me show you how I made some of my snakes. One of the things I did is sometimes when you look at pictures of Medusa, her hair is, the snakes are all twisted together. So I started twisting these together like this. And you can twist them together as much as you want. You can also coil your snakes like that by wrapping it around your finger. So like that, and it'll coil up. But to get the snake-looking head, I twisted this around and around into a circle until it was big enough to look like a snake head. See that? Take a stapler. And you would staple them to the edge of your paper plate. And you can add as many of these as you want. Now, you don't have to coil all of them. Some of them you can just wrap around your finger and then sort of pull it out, spring. And then, of course, you twist up the head and attach. Once this is all done, you put it together. And I drew a face that I thought would look kind of like Medusa. But then I thought, you know, I think I like that one better. I hope you've enjoyed today's craft and learning about euphorbias and the Medusa euphorbias. To find out more about these crafts and plants and Greek mythology, please go to bcpl.info. Look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you.